You say ago kakailan tutun ud yagagayam sakun gayam si Aveline Elsie and welcome to my channel. In my previous video, which is better, taking TOEIC in the Philippines or in Thailand? Here are my top 5 early commenters. Yaman! In this video, I'm going to share 6 tips on how to get hired immediately in Thailand. Number 1. You must be in Thailand during the hiring season. Thai schools want teachers who are already in Thailand to be considered a serious applicant. It is applicable to all nationalities. The hiring season for the first term starts as early as March until early May. In some schools, they start as early as May 1st. Some schools start on the second week or third week of May. The hiring season for the second term starts as early as September until October. Classes in some schools start as early as November 1st. You can go to Thailand in between these months if your friend or family members assure you that there is a job vacancy in their school or in schools they know. But if you are like me who can only rely on yourself, make sure to go to Thailand during the hiring season. Tip number 2. Must have complete documents. You must have authenticated documents for better chances of being hired immediately. Remember, there are schools who require authenticated documents and there are schools who don't. I suggest that you should process the authentication of your documents before leaving the Philippines for you not to spend much. These are the following: authenticated transcript of records or TOR and diploma, resume or curriculum vitae, NBI clearance or Thai police check. For the Thai police check, you cannot go directly to the police station and get a Thai police check or clearance. Your school will endorse you. Your school will give you a letter that you have to present at a Royal Police Station. TOEIC score certificate. The higher, the better. It will help you give better chances to stand out among other applicants. Tip number 3. Send as many resumes as you can. The more you send or submit your resume, the greater chance to get hired immediately. When sending your application online, make sure that you match the qualification. If the job advert wants a native or NES, you may try at your own risk. This is not to scare you, but then, some schools really prefer natives. I just don't want you to get embarrassed. Tip number 4. Know how to sell yourself. Well, it's up to you on how you perceive it. Let me tell you that you should exude or show a positive aura. Being friendly is the key. Always wear a sweet smile on your face during the interview and demo teaching. Why? As you greet your interviewers, teachers, and staffs in the school. And don't forget to dress professionally. Tip number 5. Prepare an interactive lesson for demo teaching. Utilize student talk time and reduce teacher talk time as much as you can. Don't forget to prepare rewards and incentives. Introduce simple classroom rules. Explain briefly the consequences of misbehaviors during the class. Tip number 6. Prepare answers for possible interview questions. You may search the internet for usual interview questions. Usually, they will ask questions related on real-life classroom situations. For example, how are you going to handle misbehaving students during the class? How are you going to motivate your students who don't want to learn English? When you get hired, make sure that you read the content of the contract before signing and ask additional details if you are not sure of something. You may watch my video about 8 things to consider before signing a teaching contract to give you additional information before deciding to sign a teaching contract. If you find this video informative and helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, comment, and share it to your friends. In my next video, I'm going to talk about tips and tricks in teaching young learners. See you in my next video. Yaman!